Hey guys, welcome to DevTech Finance. In this video, we would be covering the topic Marine Insurance. This video is a part of General Insurance module, so I recommend you to watch all other related videos to get a better understanding on the whole syllabus. Here we will be discussing about the meaning, types, coverages and exclusions and the policies of Marine Insurance. So let's start with the introduction. Now, Marine Insurance is a form of General Insurance. All the non-life insurances are referred as general insurance. So, marine insurance is one such type. Now, it provides the coverages against the loss or damage of ship, cargo. Cargo is the goods that is transferred from the ship from one destination to another. Hull. Hull is the outer body of the ship and any other equipment and transport which happens between the point of origin till the final destination of voyage. So all that is covered under marine insurance, which is a general insurance type. The loss or damages which is occurring in between the trip in form of goods damage, hull damage, equipment damage, etc. It works as a contract where the insurer undertakes the responsibility to indemnify the insured in case of any damage or loss as mentioned in the policy. So it works as an insurance contract, obviously, where the insurer or the insurance company, it undertakes the responsibility as mentioned in the policy that if any losses or damages happen to the ship during the trip, so I will be indemnifying for that loss. I will be paying the coverage amount if you have taken the insurance. Now let's see about the coverages and exclusions in marine insurance. So the perils covered are loss due to bad weather. So it happens that when there is a voyage going on, it may be the weather may be bad because of which the destructions happened, the goods are damaged, etc. So any loss due to bad weather, loss due to high waves and collision with another ship or any other thing, loss due to fire, loss due to pirates attack, all these perils or risks are covered under marine insurance policy. Now, exclusions, what could be? So, loss or damage due to unsuitable or defective packaging. So, this is not something uncertain. This is due to someone's fault. So, this is not covered. This is due to the owner's negligence, the owner's fault. Because the unsuitable or defective packaging that would ultimately lead to damage to the goods, and that won't be making the insurance company responsible for providing the coverage amount for your default. So loss or expense proximately caused by delay. If you are delaying, if you are not transporting the ships or any other thing as per the contract with the sales with the other person, and if there is any delay because of which the buyer is not paying you the full amount, so that losses won't be covered by the insurance company. Loss or damage due to willful misconduct. So these are all examples of willful misconduct only. If you are responsible for any negligence or any loss or damage, that won't be making you eligible for any coverage from the insurance company. Only things that were not in your hand, any uncertain event has made damages or losses, that would be covered by insurance company, not anything by your fault. Now let's see some of the types of marine insurance. So first is cargo insurance. Cargo insurance covers cargo or goods. So cargo is exactly the goods that is carried by the ship, that is referred as cargo. And cargo insurance provides coverage for goods of certain specified value throughout the journey from beginning point of departure till its arrival at destination. So in between the voyage, in between the trip, there are many mishappenings could occur, which may lead to damage of the goods, which is referred as cargo over here. So all that would be covered under cargo insurance. So this is one such type of marine insurance, which covers the goods that is being carried from one point to another. Second is hull insurance. Hull insurance is an insurance policy specially designed for covering ship damage expenses where the hull refers to the main body of the ship. So as I already told about this, that hull is the outer body of the ship. So any damage which is happening to the ship due to high waves, bad weather, collision, etc. So that would be covered under this marine insurance policy. Along with this outer body coverage, it also provides coverage to equipments, machinery and furnitures, all that are there in the ship. Then there could be freight insurance. Now the amount paid to the owner of ship for transferring goods from one port to another is called freight. So you are paying the amount to the owner of ship if you are a business dealer and you have to transfer the goods from one destination to another. So that you would be paying the amount that is called freight. Now freight insurance provides coverage against loss in form of freight in case cargo is lost due to accident or any unseen event before reaching the destination. Okay, so your goods have not reached the destination due to any uncertainty and because of that the seller won't be paying you the freight. Besides, you have carried the goods that had made you incur expenses. So that loss in form of freight will be covered under freight insurance. Liability insurance covers for any liability in form of compensation to be paid to the third party arising out of losses caused due to crashes or collision with another ship. So liability insurance is that your responsibility when you are damaging third party. So the losses that are arising due to third party damage. So maybe that it happens that your ship collided with another ship and their ship has incurred many damages and losses. Now that party has put a suit against you in the court and asking for compensation. So that would be covered under liability insurance. If you have taken this, you can pay the compensation. The insurance company would be providing the compensation amount asked by the third party. Then there is types of marine policy. So first is voyage policy. Now this marine insurance policy provide coverage against losses during a particular voyage. So it is covering against the risk or damages which would occur during a particular voyage or trip. So voyage is nothing but a trip from the time ship leaves the port of departure and reaches the port of destination. So all in between that particular trip, if any damage or loss happens, that would be covered under voyage policy. Second is time policy. Now in this, what happens, it provides coverage for a fixed period of time, generally which is for a year. So from the date like 15 March 2018 to 15 March 2019, if the insurance company had provided coverage, so that is a time policy. Because it is providing you coverage for a fixed period of time. Now, irrespective of when your ship will be leaving the port, when it will be reaching the destination, the only thing to be considered is that should be within that time frame, which is usually a year. Mixed policy. The joint form of voyage and time policy is called a mixed policy. So, it is when an insurance company is providing you policy which is providing you coverage against any risk or losses or damage occurring to your ship during a particular trip which is valid for a certain period. So this was only for a particular trip happening and it was valid for a certain period. So it is combination of both the voyage and the time policy which is referred as mixed policy. Then there is port risk policy. The port risk policy provides coverage against any loss or damage while ship is stationed at port. So ships, majorly they are stationed at port for many long times and it happens that many damages occur during that time also when the ship is not on the voyage, not on the trip, but stationed at the port. So any risk or damage occurring during that time can be covered under port risk policy. Thank you for watching. Do like and share my video. Subscribe to my channel, Dave Take Finance. Thank you all.